Hello everybody, my name is Alanator, and welcome back to Minecraft Legacy! So, as you can see, I reorganized this because it wasn't really suiting the proper layout and whatnot, so I fixed that, made it look all nice, so I got all my stuff in there, so I got all my ores, and as you can see, I created a bunch of stone slabs for use, because I figured out how I plan on doing it, so I'm going to go all the way around the tops of these, and then I'm going to have a layer of cobble to count as the full block between them. Here, I'm just going to hop on up and show you all. I actually need to pull out a stack of slabs. Okay, so I'm going to do that, and then I'm going to do that. So, all the way around now, I'm going to want to mess up as little as possible, because one cobble equals one slab, unfortunately, and these are a pain to make. And also, if you break a double slab, it will still only drop one. So, unfortunately about that. But I'm gonna keep on building. So I'm gonna go all the way around, then I'm gonna do a layer of cobble behind that. And also, I think I did show you, but I did also collect a bunch of sand since the last episode. So I'm gonna go all the way around. So finally, it's like we didn't do nearly this much building in Nostalgia. So, I'm grateful for that, since building, it is a strong point for me in Minecraft. I would say I'm a good builder. The greatest? Probably not. I've seen some like mega builds that are like, oh my goshness. However, I actually have been working on something with PyJ, and it's turning out very, very nice. Like, it is, it's looking a lot better than some of my previous stuff, so I'm very happy with how it's turning out. But, you guys will need to wait until I release the trailer for that. And that probably won't be for another few weeks or so. I mean, I'm hoping no longer. Well, I want to release before summer, but, other people actually do care about their grades in school and whatnot, like me. It's like, school, it's not my thing. I feel much better at home, where I can make videos, and I could work on independence with as much time as I want. So yeah, I am on spring break right now. So I am happy about that, and I realize might have some difficulty going on to the next level. So I'm trying to mentally piece this all out, because I could do one layer of slab. Well, once I have the layer of slabs, doing the layer of cobble is going to be easy. However, it's going to be difficult doing another layer of, resupply the goods, doing another layer of slabs next to that, or after that layer. So it is difficult. I don't want to fall, because, sorry, all this dirt and whatnot. I picked it up, right?
Yeah.
Sorry. It's hard to tell, because things, you know you picked it up when it disappears, so it's kind of hard to tell, because it doesn't have a little pickup animation. Now, we'll throw something on the ground. Here, I'll show you. Boop, just disappears, so. I would have thrown some on the ground, but throwing things on the ground is much more unpredictable than in current versions. They just go, like, all over the place, so it's not like it's in the same spot every time. Like, stuff goes flying everywhere. One more block. Now, this is actually a very efficient building method. sides, as you can see. With one block, I'm able to cover two sides. Now, I've been using this technique for a long time, and it is very useful. I just gotta keep track on what's the Sigma blob, and I'm actually starting to run low on cobble. I'll run low on cobble eventually. However, I realize that I'm gonna have about as much cobble as about as much stone slabs, and I realize, well, in the end, that's how much it's gonna take. But it occurred to me that, like, oh, wait a minute, I only have, like, 4 stacks of cobble, and, like, almost 15 stacks of slabs. So, I'm gonna run out of cobble much before I'm gonna run out of slabs. So remember, each one of these slabs was equivalent to one cobble block. So, I've collected quite a bit of cobble so far. No! Pancakes! I got it. I might as well fix it now. While I'm here, I might as well destroy this dirt pillar. Pancakes! That's just frustrating. I'm trying to see. Okay, good. So, slabs don't cast shadows. I don't think they ever do. Well, and lighting is much more premature in this version, so it will not turn out. Oh, come on! As so much less things actually cast lighting. Same thing with stairs. Stair light. Actually, no. It's an alpha where stairs have broken lighting. It's alpha 1.2.2, I believe, where they no longer cast shadows or block light. And I couldn't figure out why, because I don't think, like, anything big changed to stairs in alpha 1.2. Like, very few things changed between 1.2.0 and 1.2.6. So, I'm not quite sure. Oh, no, lag, go away. So, The last video, I didn't realize until I was, like, already recording. I was like, oh, wrong screen recorder. But the last Minecraft Nostalgia Minecraft Legacy episode was recorded using XSplit, because that runs smoother than Fraps. But I still like Fraps because it does do the full 1080p. And I'm actually recording in 120fps, because if I recorded in 60, like, 60 is the maximum. So, in the end, I need to limit Minecraft FPS, because my power supply by now is wee bit outdated, and it is not fully work with my new graphics card. Yeah. The 1080 is more power hungry than the 750 Ti, I believe. I'm trying to look back and remember. Oopsies. Simple fix, as long as I actually pick it up. So, I do have a new one. I'm going from a 600 watt to a 850 watt. Oh, sorry, yeah, 850. So, I should be good after that, but I'm waiting because I've been saving up for a new CPU and motherboard. I might have told you all this. So, I'm going from a i5 4590 to an i7 6800K. And then, don't remember the name of my current motherboard, but I'm going to a... I'm trying to remember. Asus X, it's either 79 or 99-A2, I believe. 70, 79A2, I believe. I look back at that and actually look at the full price yet. So I should no longer need to limit the FPS of things and whatnot. Same thing with the BioShock Remastered. That was when I first discovered the power problem was on BioShock Remastered. The first BioShock Remastered, because there was a certain area where a power would, or my computer would just shut down because of power surge. I like that, I think, what the exact error was. So then that would cause my problems, and then the BIOS would start up. So I'm like, oh boy, well, that was frustrating. So now I know just limit frame rate or turn on VSync, and that fixes the problem. Same thing with that fixes the problem with Minecraft. All versions. Like, however, though, late classic Minecraft didn't get a limit frame rate until 0.30. However, 0.24 has a whatchamacallit. You are the so far the only classic version. Other than, like, old classic, like, pre-0.24, pre-survival test, that has its own different way of saving stuff. So, oh my goshness, I'm messing up, I'm talking too much. But, no! I'll get it soon enough. Actually, no, I might as well get it now, even though I'm already at 12 minutes. Man, these videos are ending up longer than I wanted them. Well, that's fine. So, I am able to save 0.24 worlds. However, it's in a different format than InDev. And that's frustrating because, I swear, the save format changed like 3 different times between InDev and Classic. Let's see, there's the dot dat, which is like the old, so from like 0.9 to 0.23. So those, I'm pretty sure they save in a dot dat, and that's just one world. That's just from my experience from playing around with them in the new launcher. Then InDev, or let's see, survival test, 0.24 to 0.30 saves in .mine, I believe. Now, unfortunately, I can't load a 0.24 world in 0.30, but if I was able to, I would have started Minecraft Legacy in 0.24. when survival was first added. So, then after that, 0.31 and InDev save in .mc level. So, I am able. So, I think a dot mine is able to be opened in MC Edit, but I don't remember too much. I haven't tried it in a while. But dot MC level, I'm surprised. They have in dev, or in the latest version of MC Edit, you can open the newest format, which is Anvil, I believe, .mcr and .mca for the regions. But you can also open MC levels, so every version of MC Edit has always had in-dev support. But the MC Edit, the newest versions, don't have the old alpha and pre-1.2 save format, like region, I believe. So, it's all complicated. but it's fine. I just wish, there's no easy way to convert a dot mine to a dot MC level. But if there was, I would have waited on Legacy and started in Survival Test 0.24. I'm gonna tear down this pillar because I need a bunch more cobble. So after I get more cobble, I'm gonna be working more on the roof. And where is it? This one? Nope, just kidding. Wait, oh no, am I gonna need... oopsies. Oh my gosh, miss. Hold up, I got this. I game of the year. So, yeah. Ooh. This is gonna be interesting, because it's gonna be shadow, light, all the way around. So, this is gonna look pretty interesting. So... I don't need to do it right now. So, my house is really looking a lot like a lot nicer now. So, thank you all for watching. Bye.